Exactly 100 years ago, Hibernian Hall was built in 1913 by the Ancient Order of Hibernians to support the Irish community here in Boston. For nearly 50 years, it served as a center of music, dance, social gatherings, and political activity for Boston's Irish community. And since then, it has always been associated with helping communities in need, economically, socially, and politically. As Roxbury changed, so did the hall. But throughout its 100-year history, its mission has always stayed steady, supporting immigrants and communities of color in the Dudley Square area.
Well, today, Hibernian Hall is the only Irish dance hall that's still standing, actually, in Dudley Square. And it really was one of the very most popular at the time. And from the 1920s or so until at least the early 1960s, it was really the very center of Irish culture life in Boston. Those five dance halls attracted thousands of young Irish people every weekend to dance, but also to socialize, to find a job. If you had just come from Ireland to America, or if you were a young Irish American and you wanted to find a mate, you wanted to find a job, this was the place you went to do that.
Well, first of all, the pay rate was a dollar. In fact, my first time playing actually in a band for pay, I made 65 cents for the night, for 4 hours. 65 cents with the Emeldine Orchestra. Then I would go downstairs to what they call Mal's drugstore like, and you would get a piece of blueberry pie and a soda. And on the train, it was only 10 cents to go all the way back to Somerville. Thing. Yeah. So that's what that was like. It was just awesome to be playing there. And the biggest one was, I told you, when the fellow brings me from upstairs, because at the second floor was a hall maybe twice as big as this room. We played strictly set dancing, group dancing, and some waltzes and some polkas. And upstairs was maybe 50. You could hear the feet in the ballroom upstairs, a big crystal ballroom there. So you would, that's where all the action was up there.
This dance hall was, when the Orange Line came from Forest Hills into Dudley Street, it would squeak around this corner, and it was almost a deafening sound. But the band played on, and nobody missed a beat on the floor, and the floor reverberated. And it was just the most wonderful, exciting, couldn't wait for Saturday night.
Change was very rapid after the Second World War, and the Ancient Order of Hibernians who ran the building tried to adapt. They certainly provided space and time here for bar mitzvahs and other Jewish ceremonial occasions. And when blacks started moving in great numbers, they also tried to accommodate that audience, and they booked people like James Brown and his famous Flames, even before he was famous in the 50s, and several other black bands.
By the 1960s, a large part of the Irish population had left Greater Boston for the suburbs, and the neighborhood transitioned to become mostly African American. And so as the community changed, Hibernian Hall adapted to the new needs of this population. In the 1970s, the building became Boston's location for the Opportunities Industrialization Center, or OIC.
And this was an organization founded by a guy named Reverend Leon Sullivan out of Philadelphia. And his mission was to help the blacks who were now gaining the rights to get jobs, to get the skills they needed to keep those jobs. His mission was about job training. And he brought not only technical training to communities like Roxbury around the country, but also life skill training as well.
Not only did they have machine tool, but they had clerical, they had electronics, they had printing, English as a second language. So that in itself was almost like going to college or going to school. So that way there, they'd have a better chance of employment going down to the employment office and place. They got some kind of a skill. They got some kind of training.
So I believe if I hadn't worked at, came here to OIC for the training, I probably would have been still working like in factory type works, or wouldn't have had the courage to go back to school, or wouldn't have been able to work in banking and nonprofit organizations.
I think what's great about celebrating our 100th anniversary is the fact that Hibernian Hall has stayed true to its original purpose and mission of being a social and cultural and economic center for immigrants coming to Boston. And so initially it was the Irish community that started the hall, but over time when OIC came in, it was about training the African American community that was here in Boston. And today, Madison Park purchased this building in 2000 because we saw the tremendous potential of this building helping to continue the renaissance of Dudley Square.
I thought it couldn't get better. It was absolutely amazing.